Hello guys, my name is Guest and I'm bringing you guys some kill confirmed on the map Village, and you guys will see me using the striker, the golden beautiful striker in the beginning of the match, but I quickly realized that the striker isn't the greatest gun to use on this map. But I was trying to go for a rushing gameplay, so I'm not gonna switch out to like Type 95 or an MK14 or any assault rifle. I'm gonna switch over to a nice, what's it called, P90, because in the beginning of Modern Warfare 3 I fell in love with the P90. That was the only thing I used, but then I switched to the MP7 and then I switched to the PP90 and MK14 and a lot of stuff, because I think variety of guns is pretty important. Like, I can always use like one of the same gun and do well at it with it, and it's just not interesting, you know. You want to see some shotgun, you want to see some sniping, you want to see some light machine gun that I still didn't upload any gameplay of, but it will come, don't worry. And I have found that if you play freaking team deathmatch for too long, it gets so frustrated, because the team deathmatch players, I'm just gonna say it, like 70% of them are assholes. They're playing like bitches. They just sit in the corner with their blind eye and assassin, and even dead silence. I'm not even sure why they use dead silence. It's just gay. And then I'm like thinking, why am I playing team deathmatch? But I did another like stuff, you know, with Call of Duty Elite, that I could win something and I need to play like team deathmatch, but it didn't go well at all. I was doing poorly, super poorly, because I got like my max skills were like 30 or something, and that's not good. Normally I get like at least 30 kills and highest something like 40 or something, and then you see only like 20, 15 and 25, and you're like disappointment in yourself, because you know you can do better, but it's just frustrating. That's why I like to play Kill Confirmed, because I think it's way better, and I hope it's gonna come in Black Ops and all of the other things that Modern Warfare do that wrong, not like bad spawn system. Like, come on. If you play team deathmatch, your spawn system is horribly, it's super bad. Like, any other game type is way better to play, because the spawns aren't as ridiculous as in freaking a team deathmatch. Like, in Kill Confirmed they are pretty decent, you know. You don't spawn in the back of a guy that often, because it still happens, you know, people spawn right in front of me, but less than in team deathmatch, because I have clips, but I don't record them, because I think it's a waste of time. But I have like clips that I'm just running around and I see the enemy spawning in front of me. I think that they patched it, that it don't supposed to happen. Like, it's not okay if I see an enemy spawn right in front of me. It's not okay, and it's not okay like saying, yeah, we're gonna fix the spawn system, you will not see anybody spawn in front of you and spawn in your back. It's pretty gay too, you know. If you're trying to go for streaks, or you just don't want to rush as badly, you know, you never save, because they are just gonna spawn in your back and all that stupid stuff. I don't like it at all. But yeah, I'm using the P90, sorry guys, because the PP90 is just so powerful up close. And yeah, and I need to switch gun, because I'm not running scavenger, I'm just running a kill streak. So then most of the time I'm not running scavenger, only like in guns who has a low amount of ammo, like the MK14. I think it only has 40 bullets, and it's pretty low for an assault rifle. But I don't know, I think I'm gonna quit playing team deathmatch like completely, because don't get me wrong, on Black Ops I loved playing team deathmatch. It was my favorite game type, mainly because the spawns weren't as horrible as in freaking Modern Warfare 3, because the only the only map where you can say like, oh, they spawned in my back was Nuketown. Because if you rushed too much, like in their spawn, it would switch pretty fast. And like whole game you would just switch spawns and flip the spawn all the time to one side to the other. And the only thing you actually could do was sit behind the truck and get a shit ton of kills, because that truck, if you blew it up, it was amazing. It had all kind of covers. And then you use Flag Jacket and Tactical Mask Pro. I love Tactical Mask, and the Flag Jacket in this game is poorly. It doesn't protect you from anything, actually. Like, the grenades kills you, and yeah, I don't think it's good. And the pro ability is even bad, because they say like, yeah, you're protected against flash and flash and all the other stuff. It's not true. I get flashed when I have the specialist bonus. I still get like flashed for like 15 seconds or something. It's like, no, it's not helping anything, because on Black Ops it was amazing. You guys will maybe think like, if you like Black Ops that much, why don't you go play it? I don't know, because mainly what people want to see is the newest game. People want to see Modern Warfare 3. And I paid for the game, so I'm actually gonna play it. It's like, I paid a lot of money because I got like the Hardened Edition. I'm like, I'm gonna play the living shit out of this game because I want to get my money out of it. Just the same with Call of Duty Elite. I'm gonna try to do as many, what's stupid of me, as many challenges and other stuff that I can possibly do, because I paid money for it, so why not do it, like use it. I see people who buy Elite and don't do anything with it. I'm like, no, I'm not that kind of guy. If I buy something, I want to use it as much as possibly. Maybe it sounds cheap or something, but it's how it should be, you know. It's how it should be. But yeah, and just trying to rape everybody in their spawn. And actually, I died a lot in this game, mainly because I was using the Striker in the beginning, and I made some stupid decisions in this game. So learn, guys. And do I get the third guy? No, he gets me. It would be an awesome triple spray, but it's some Reaper time. Da-da-da-dum. It's not copyrighted because it's me, you know? You probably thought it was some music, but no, it's just my amazing voice again. I'm a little cocky, I know. But it's good, you know? It's not like the douchebaggery cocky, but the good amount of cocky that a guy needs, you know, to say like, I'm awesome, and the good guy and stuff like that. But actually, I have a question for you guys. If you guys could have like a shit ton of money, like sincerely not like 500,000 money, but a shit ton of money, and the only thing that you need to do was to risk your life for it, I'm not talking like 400,000, 500,000 euros or dollars or whatever it is, I'm talking about 15 to 20 million dollars or euros or whatever it is, would you risk your life for it? Like, I think I would, you know, like, it's a lot of money, it's actually a lot of money, and wouldn't, you know, $20 million, you can do a lot of with $20 million, you can do a lot, like, you can buy fancy cars, give awesome parties, buy the latest technology and stuff, you know, because I'm a nerd like that. No, but hope you guys enjoyed it, and let me know if you guys would do it. Leave a like, share it with